Boston Marathon bomb and suspect, Abdul Rahman Ali al-Harabi, visited the White House 3 times since 2009. This is according to the Right Scoop, which catalogs the logs from the White House of all visitors. He is on there. I will give you the link. I mean, the plot is thickening on this. As one person joked in the comments section, the person of interest lives in the White House. This guy's brother, older brother, was part of the Mujahideen that the United States funded. So no doubt, the United States government funded this guy. He was at the Boston Marathon. He was close enough to be injured, enough to be hospitalized, and received several surgeries, including beautification surgeries. What is that? They have that in regular hospitals? Beautification surgeries? I never heard of that in my life. But this guy has ties to the Saudi royal family. He was given an international cell phone, called up. Next thing you know, John Kerry is pulled out of all the other world affairs, you know, like North Korea and other things, and he's going to Boston to meet with the Saudi ambassador. Obama is meeting with the Saudi ambassador and other Saudi diplomats. And pretty soon, the story is changing and changing. No one knows anything about this guy now. You know, it starts from he's a terrorist. He is part of the Boston Marathon bombing. And now he's, who's he? Gianni Napolitano? I'm not even going to answer that question. There is a huge cover-up. And this is time for Americans to stand up and demand their congressmen do their job. Because this is a threat to national security. We were bombed on Marathon Day. And we were bombed from within. It's pretty apparent. This guy has 6 members of his family on the Saudi terrorist watch list. What is that? Is that a temp agency? I don't understand that. He's got 6 of his members of his family on the terror watch list from Saudi Arabia, yet he's not a person of interest. He was on the no-fly zone, no-fly list. An event file was taken out on him, calling him a terrorist. That event file was changed. There were several attempts to remove it completely. There is a huge cover-up here. And people need to wake up. This was not an act of 2 guys from Chechnya coming here and attacking us. This was an organized event. There was a government drill going on. All these other aspects to this, it just reeks of 9/11 all over again. Let's believe the impossible. Let's believe 2 paper airplanes brought those buildings down as neat as can be, including building number 7, which Larry Finkelstein, or whatever his name is, Silverstein, said we had to pull it. Pull it is a term used in engineering and demolition. It is for imploding a building. Imploding a building takes time. You don't just set charges and an hour and have it all come down. You got to be concerned about the entire area, how that building lands, and you have to gut the basement. If you don't gut the basement, you got a huge pile and it could be like an avalanche. So what went on that day? And what went on the 15th? when Boston was attacked. Boston was attacked by Barack Hussein Obama. Barack Hussein Obama and his filthy wife visited this terrorist in the hospital to make sure his beautification surgeries were going okay. He got hit in the groin, I guess, by a glass. Where is the accountability in government? And where are the people? What are people caring about today? The NFL draft? I mean, this is more important. The president of the United States of America is in bed with terrorists. Surprise, surprise. And he has them meeting him at the White House. Can't remember the other guy from another earlier terrorist attack. Was meeting at the Pentagon, having dinner there. Why are we associated with Saudi Arabian terrorists? Why are we funding Chechen rebels to go screw around with the Russians? And then those Chechen rebels come back here because they're so useful. That's what it's all about. They're so useful, they brought them back here to use them on the United States. There's something much deeper going on here. And we need answers. This guy visited the White House and stayed there. He might have stayed overnight for as long as he was there. I mean, I would think a White House tour, because that's what it's listed as, would be like, you walk through and maybe it's like an hour, 45 minutes, half hour. I wouldn't think it would be several hours. You know what several hours means? A meeting. Or he slept there. Who else is going to the White House? It's a disgrace. They need to impeach him. And I think they might have to destroy the White House. It is now cursed. The terrorists that are walking through there, it is cursed. We need a new White House. But no one seems to care. This guy visited the White House. He was on the terror watch list. He was on the no-fly list. He was in violation of his visa. He did not go to his point of destination, Findlay, Ohio. Never registered for school. Was at the Boston Marathon bombing. And seen close to the explosion. Close enough that he got hit in the nuts. Is this a coincidence? 5 or 6 of his members of his family are on a terror watch list. His family excels at this. This is their trade. But what you have to do is you have to call up your congressman and your senator and harass them. Ask them what they're doing about it. Because if this doesn't shake them, you know who the enemy is and how far it extends. And it would extend to your senator or your congressman if they don't care about this. If they don't care that Barack Hussein Obama is entertaining members of terrorism, architects behind the Boston Marathon bombing. If he doesn't care about this, and your senator doesn't care, and your congressman, who do you got to turn to? We have provisions in the Constitution for this. It says, if our government does not represent us, we can remove them from office. We appointed them, and we can remove them. This is not a country club. It's about time it was not deemed such. Because American rights are being taken away every day. Lie after lie. Lying about all these suspects. How, you know, they acted on their own and they listened to too much Alex Jones, so yeah, they became radicalized. He always talks about going radical. Imagine that. This guy went to the White House. Went to the White House, hung around with Barack Hussein Obama, hung around with Michelle Hussein Obama, talked about how to kill Americans. How can we kill Americans the best way? Yes. Pressure cookers, nails, ball bearings. I wonder what Michelle Obama contributed to the whole discussion. She met him in the hospital too. There's pictures of her in the hospital with the Saudi terrorist. The Boston Marathon Saudi terrorist. Do you understand that? You're from Boston. You saw the bomb go off. You heard the bomb go off. You saw the bloody bodies. You saw the limbs flying around. Guess what? It was Saudi Arabia behind the whole thing. But guess where Saudi Arabia is? They're in the White House. They're going to the White House. I would think, now that I really believe, Barack Hussein Obama, Barry Soatorio, whatever his name is a Saudi Arabian. Just look at his name. This is ridiculous. Obama? Osama? It's a made-up name anyway. That's not his name. His name is Barry. And who knows where he comes from. But he met with terrorists in the White House, at the hospital. And you need to contact your senators and congressmen and demand answers. If they have no answers, like I said, there are ways to remove them from office. We do not deserve this. We do not deserve domestic terrorism because people like Devil Patrick, Devil, D-E-V-I-L, Patrick, and others allowed these filthy scum to come in here. Barack Obama, last January, signed an executive order, I think it was January 14th, that stated all Saudi Arabians, including terrorists, would be on the trusted traveler list. That means they just walk through an airport. Hey, I'm Saudi, I got pressure cooker with nails with the top snipped off. Took a long time, and we got ball bearings and gunpowder that we got from fireworks, and we're going to blow up Americans.
Have a nice day, sir.
That's what it's become. Saudi Arabia is on the trusted traveler list, which includes Canada and Mexico. Mexico? Drug cartels? England is not on there. Other so-called allies like Israel, I would not trust them. I wouldn't even trust England, but this trusted traveler crap, I actually wouldn't trust any of them. Because people could come in through Canada, and they do. This guy was at the White House. He met with Barack Hussein Obama at the White House. He met with Barack Hussein Obama in the hospital. He was at the Boston Marathon. His family is terrorists. All a bunch of terrorists. And he was allowed to go free. You want to make a bet? He'll be back. Because he's a trusted traveler. He does not have to be vetted. Call your congressman, call your senator, demand answers. Why was the Boston Marathon terrorist at the